India. I would like to thank Dr. Bansi Sabu and the whole team of DiCare for having me here in this prestigious event. Today I'm going to talk about a newer gliptin by the name of evogliptin and what is the evidence it has in comparison to other gliptins. So as you know that DPP-4 has in the last 1.5 decades has actually captured our mind space, especially in oral antidiabetic therapy, because of drug, very minimal drug-to-drug interactions, insulinotropic, low risk of hypoglycemia, weight neutrality, and backed by extensive scientific evidence. And why this has occurred is because paradoxical high glucagon has been a pathophysiological defect, and today we know that alpha cells plays a huge role in the pathophysiology of type 2 diabetes. And we all know that how much one glucose lowering medications actually cause in randomized controlled trials. But DPP-4 are considered as placebos in the Western world, but today we know that they can cause an easily 1 to 1.5% reduction in HbA1c. Now, evogliptin is a very selective, potent, reversible inhibitor. It has been extensively studied for its efficacy and safety. It's been approved in Azerbaijan, Russia, South Korea, Bolivia for the treatment of type 2 diabetes as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control. Dosage is 5 milligrams OD. If you look at the DPP-4 enzyme with its binding site, this makes the difference between various DPP-4 inhibitors, and that sets them apart. S1, S2 is considered as fundamental binding and required for to produce DPP-4 inhibition. X2 extensive as well as S1 and S2 binding to this produce more inhibition of DPP-4. Wilda and Saxa bind exclusively to S1 and S2. Allo and Lina in addition to S1 and S2. Sitra, Tenli and Evo bind also to X2 extensive, and this is a non-covalent binding. If you look at the IC50, which actually talks about potency, when we talk about IC50, it's very, if you see, it's only 0.98 nanomoles is required. If you look at off-target actions of this particular gliptin, which is evogliptin as compared to other gliptins, it's off-target actions on DPP-8 and DPP-9, which causes immunological and skin-related reactions, is very, very limited. Hence, we are using a very safe gliptin. Look at the pharmacokinetics. Bioavailability is good, peaks at 3 to 5 hours. 80% DPP-4 inhibition, half-life is 32 hours, and no dosage adjustment is required because urinary excretion is not the major pathway for elimination. Dosage and administration dosage is not needed in patients with mild to moderate hepatic impairment. If you look at the favorable pharmacokinetics, it is once a day dosing, thus improving compliance. Excretion mainly hepatic and lesser by renal, so hence we can use it in patients with chronic kidney disease. It reduces the PPGLP1 by 1.5, sorry, increases by 1.5 to 2.5 fold. It reduces PPG levels by 20 to 35%. DPP-4 inhibition is increased in a dose-dependent manner and remained for more than 80% over 24 hours. If you look at the landscape of evogliptin, it's one of the gliptins which doesn't come as the support of a big MNC, but it has amassed a lot of scientific evidence, and most important, various kind of indications, and importantly, also which are the standard of care as far as DPP. First, you look at a placebo-controlled study, then we look at head-on studies, and then we look at the double-blind, double-dummy study as well. So here you look at the placebo-controlled study of evogliptin versus placebo with the 60 patients. You had a reduction of 0.3%, which was considered statistically significant. So monotherapy, obviously, the first proof of concept of the proof of the pudding lies in monotherapy, and as you can see, it is found to be good. Brazilian study, again, you have an active comparator. As you can see 3 doses of evogliptin versus sitagliptin patients followed up over 12 weeks, almost 150 patients. And you can see that once a day evo was one safe and well tolerated, Adverse events were similar. HbA1c was very similar between SITA and evogliptin in monotherapy. Evergreen study presented at the ADA in 2019 looked at CGM. Gliptins, and then again it was also to find out the glycerin CGMS at 0 and after 12 weeks. You can see HbA1c reduction numerically better with evogliptin as compared to linagliptin. HbA1c reduction, more patients reaching a goal with evo as compared to lina, whether it's 7% or 6.5%. Mean amplitude of glycemic excursion and standard deviation coefficient of variation better with evogliptin as compared to linagliptin. So glycemic of 24 weeks, more patients had a much better control and more durable control with evogliptin as compared to linagliptin. Again, as the response rate is higher with evo as compared to linagliptin. If you look at the glycemic profile and you look at the variability, which today is a very important marker, and TIR, we can see that evogliptin had more patients in the TIR as compared to linagliptin. So conclusion was that evogliptin in this particular study is safe and effective, improved glycemic variability, and was non-inferior to linagliptin. Again, it has a study done in mild to moderate renal dysfunction. The number of patients is very low, 30 only, but still it's a proof of concept that you can use it in patients with chronic kidney disease as well as in patients with hepatic impairment, and there's no extra exposure of the drug which will have any kind of deleterious side effects. If you look at this nation-based cohort study in South Korea, again it is a retrospective study, but the whole idea was we cannot have a CVOT on this particular molecule, but the whole idea was to evaluate the association between the use of DPP-4, evogliptin and other DPP-4 and the risk of cardiovascular disease when compared to other second-line antidiabetic drugs. I will go fast to it. It's a large study with 23,000 patients comparing evogliptin and other gliptins. As you can see, evogliptin, there were almost 3,000 patients in this arm, and there were effective SGLT2 users, and you had almost 100,000 patients who on sitagliptin. If you look at the end of the longitudinal database of South Korea, it clearly showed that DPP-4 inhibitors were associated with a decreased risk of cardiovascular disease when compared to glimepiride, quite contrasting to the Carolina, but SGLT2 and DPP-4 had a null association, so seems to be similar. This is data from Korea. Again, you can conclude that compared to glimepiride users, DPP-4 users were associated with a decreased risk of cardiovascular disease. Evogliptin users were also associated with a decreased risk of cardiovascular disease. There were approximately 3,000 patients in this particular group. If you look at data of evogliptin plus metformin, it has been approved, as you can see, in 7 countries of the world, with India being the last. We're going to look at a few studies, a few head-on studies, few Indian studies to actually put forward the concept of evogliptin plus metformin as such. This is an international study which looked at the efficacy of adding evogliptin versus sitagliptin on the background of metformin. It's a 24 weeks randomized control trial with an open label extension. You can see the mean change in HbA1c is similar between evogliptin or sitagliptin when added to a background of metformin therapy. If you look at study in the Indian population, you can see that evogliptin versus sitagliptin had a similar safety and efficacy in Indian patients with type 2 diabetes. If you look at phase 3 study, which looked at the efficacy and safety of evogliptin when added to ongoing metformin therapy in patients with type 2 diabetes, you can see this is a double blind kind of a dummy study where you have evogliptin placebo and you have a sitagliptin placebo. So you are having a placebo controlled arm as well, and evogliptin is directly compared to sitagliptin on the background of metformin. If you look at the primary endpoint, both of them very similar. Similar reduction in HbA1c, whether you look at Korea plus Russian patient or just the Russian patients. If you look at combined population or just the Russian population, Evo demonstrated non-inferior to sitagliptin in terms of HbA1c reduction. Again, study of evogliptin from six studies was analyzed, and there were no reports of pancreatitis, which is a huge concern in our minds when we look at any incretin-based therapy. Again, if you look at another side effect of any therapy, hypoglycemia, again, there are no increased risk of symptomatic or asymptomatic hypoglycemia. If you look at some data which has come from India, this is presented by Abhijit Trilokia and RSSDI 2020 retrospective study, again, overall 20 patients, but does show the safety and efficacy of evogliptin in the Indian context. If you look at Indian data from a CGM data as an observational study to see the effectiveness of CGM in type 2 diabetes, and again presented at RSSDI 2020, again, a real-world setting, it shows that more percentage time was spent in range using an evogliptin as compared to other therapy as such. So as you can see, this is the efficacy and safety of metformin added to insulin therapy and evogliptin presented at the ADN 2021. Smaller number of patients, but you can see an effective reduction in HbA1c at the end of 24 weeks as such. So again, elderly is a area where we are always concerned about the side effects of drug, and DPP-4 inhibitors really comes in there because of its placebo-like side effects. And again, evogliptin has been tried in with insulin therapy in elderly patients with type 2 diabetes. And again, the conclusion was that the administration of evogliptin plus metformin could safely improve glycemic control and body weight in elderly patients with type 2 undergoing insulin therapy. Again, if you look at effects of evogliptin as add-on in inadequately controlled patients with metformin and glimepiride combination, again presented at the ADA, if you look at 185 patients, and when we add on evogliptin as a third drug, again you see a significant reduction in 24 weeks, whether it's fasting blood glucose or HbA1c at the end of 6 months of treatment. This PMS study of evogliptin plus metformin sustained release bilateral study conducted at six centers across India again shows there's an effective and durable reduction in HbA1c with a 1% drop at the end of 24 weeks. So all in all, if you look at this is the data on file of the FDC of evogliptin plus metformin, a significant reduction in HbA1c in fasting plasma glucose and postprandial at the end of 6 months. So in summary, it's truly once a day due to its ha long half-life, has safety in kidney, heart, and liver, which is the triangle we are looking at. Evergreen evogliptin shows the highest reduction in glycemic variability. HbA1c was non-inferior to Lina as well as sitagliptin, which is an Indian study. The FDC provides better compliance with convenient administration, a strong OD dosage rationale compared to an immediate release. Thank you all for a patient hearing, and thank you so much to the whole organizing committee, including Dr. Sabu, to invite me. I hope you all have a fantastic time at the conference.